Hello, everybody, and welcome to another edition of MVC 101 here on MVCSports.com. Today, we're actually joined by two guests this week from Evansville Women's Basketball. We've got head coach Oties Epps and actually the current reigning newcomer of the week in Missouri Valley Conference Women's Basketball, Sara Dickey. Oties, Sara, how are you two doing today?
Doing well. Great. Happy to be here.
All right. Thank you both for taking time out of your schedule. I know it's finals week and all kind of things going on, but wanted to get some time to visit with you two about the season so far. Coach, we'll start with you. If you can, talk a little about you guys the season so far, if you can. Evaluate where your team has gone here in the first month of the season.
Well, we're really excited about where we are. I think we're 4-5 right now. We start three freshmen. Two juniors that played half a season last year, and they're backed up by three freshmen, another junior and a senior that didn't play at all last year, and we still haven't gotten our best player from last year back in Christian Hart. And so to be 4-5 right now and to play the type of schedule that we've played up to this point, I thought we've been very competitive. Other than the Missouri game, we just didn't play well. I'm happy. You know, we've worked extremely hard to correct some of our deficiencies from last year, which were scoring the basketball. I think we had at least 5 or 6 games where we didn't even get to 50 points last year, and we're scoring that in a single half of a game now. So that says a lot about our kids and their work ethic and their energy level out there on the court, because you got to be really energetic. You got to share the basketball. You got to understand where shots are going to come from you and not be afraid to take those shots. So I couldn't be happier right now. We're young. Our best basketball is ahead of us. You know, we've got two more regular non-conference regular season games before we start Valley play, and we're looking forward to it. You know, I just don't want to finish ninth.
Completely understand. Completely understand. Now, you talk about you guys as youth. Sitting next to you, that young lady, is, as I mentioned, has been newcomer of the week. She's as of this week, and she's been newcomer of the week already, so she's been twice this year. Sara's performance this year, is that coming to a surprise here? Did you expect that the first month of the season?
Well, you know, I'm not surprised. I'm surprised she hasn't actually been player of the week both times. I think she's really deserving of it. I think where our team is at right now, where we were predicted to be, and where we're going to be in the future, I think she's a big reason for that. I knew when we recruited her that she was a special player. I was just happy that in my office that day after camp, she told me her favorite color was purple. So I knew that we had a shot. But, you know, I think she's going to be the best player ever to put on an Evansville uniform. And I don't say things like that to boast our players to make them feel good about themselves. She is extremely talented. You know, at 5'11", she can shoot the three. She can create her own offense. She can post you on the block. Her defense is improving. And beyond all that, she has the work ethic to match it. You know, we just came off a road trip on a Sunday night around midnight. I got to work at 7:45, and she was already finishing up her individual. That's the kind of character that we're talking about, and that's special, and that speaks a lot to the values of her family that they've instilled in her. And so I'm just happy to be here and to have a chance to coach a great player like this.
Now, Sara, for you, what has been the transition to Division I basketball? Has it been easy for you? Has it just been a natural progression of things?
It definitely wasn't like a natural progression. Like, the intensity of the games is so much more, and like all the workload, like all the different workouts we go through, and with all the schoolwork, it just all, you have to get used to that. But I think we're all handling it pretty well.
Sure, sure. Now, in our weekly release this week, your name was mentioned amongst some of the more notable women's basketball players in Valley history, names like Jackie Stiles. When you see your name mentioned like that, when we talk about statistics, how do you react to that? How does that make you feel in your first year?
It's just, I just like to play. So, like, get with my numbers and stuff, it doesn't really matter to me. I just like to play. Sure. It's just fun.
And I'm sure your coach appreciates that with his type of attitude, right?
Oh, yeah.
You know, the scary thing about Sara, and I've been saying this all the time, she's had some great numbers and some great games, but she hasn't played a complete game yet. She hasn't even shot the ball well yet from the field. So it's a scary thing to know that she's capable of being better. And so I'm waiting for that breakout game. She's going to drop 50 on somebody, and I can't wait to see it. And I'm not subbing her out, Derek.
Don't tell the coaches that. I'll let them watch this tape. So that probably has to give you some confidence then as a coach when you think about her performance and then putting together all the pieces on the team with Mallory and her on the court at the same time. That's got to make you feel confident then, right?
Oh, yeah. I was talking to my assistants about this earlier in the week, is that I go into these games now and I don't feel as nervous as I did in the past. A lot of that is my maturation as a coach, but also really knowing that we're putting a good product on the court, that we don't have as many weaknesses as we've had in the past. I know that teams have to deal with us, and that wasn't the case all the time. We were hoping we could keep people under 50 so we had a chance. And now we know that we can score the basketball, and so you have a little more confidence about yourself. And every day in practice is watching them practice and watching them make adjustments. That's where my confidence grows, because I don't believe that you can just show up on game day and be great. You know, I think we all have greatness within us, but it's displayed every day in what you do in practice. And our girls get better every day in practice. They value practice. And that's where it starts for us. That's the type of culture that we want to have. And Sarah's just a part of that. You know, I'm very happy for Sarah, but she's just a small part of what we're trying to accomplish here.
Sure. Now, Sarah, at Media Day, we talked to your coach in Chicago, and we asked a little laid-back questions at that point, too. But he told us that you were one of the jokesters of the team, that you were one of the folks that like to have a little fun. Is that true? Do you agree with that statement?
Oh, yeah. You got to have a little fun. Got to keep the air light in the locker room. And I don't know. I guess so.
Now, with that in mind, then, what's one of those things that you've done? I want to hear it from you that you've done that's sort of characterizes your jokester personality.
Oh, gosh. I'm not really quite sure. But all of us are pretty much jokesters, but we always have a lot of fun together.
Sure, and I'm sure that helps the team chemistry a lot.
Yeah. Helps a lot.
Well, Coach, Sarah, thank you both for taking time out of your schedule. I really appreciate it and wish you both good luck. And we'll actually see you. You guys have St. Louis on the road, non-conference game. We'll see you at Chaffetz Arena in a couple weeks.
Awesome. Thank you for having us.
Thank
and
you.
Aces up.